So guys, we've got those brand new MacBook Pros with the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. But how does the M1 Max inside the new 14-inch MacBook Pro compare to the M1 what's in the 13-inch MacBook Pro? Well, today I'm going to do a review of specs. So that's right guys, we have just seen the brand new Apple event showing us the brand new 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pros and that brand new M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset. So today, I want to do a comparison to an M1 13-inch MacBook Pro to a 14-inch M1X Max in a 14-inch MacBook Pro. So let's start doing a review specs comparison. So, as you can see here, we have the MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1 on the left, and then the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max on the right. So, let's start this comparison. So, first of all, let's talk about the display type. So, the MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1 chipset has an LED IPS technology screen inside it, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max inside it now has that mini LED or that XDR Retina display, what is a ProMotion display with adaptive refresh rate, what can go from 10Hz to 120Hz, whereas the MacBook Pro 13-inch can only stick at a 60Hz refresh rate. Then, more importantly, what you'll notice here is the actual screen size, and this actually reflects the actual name of the MacBook Pros. So we have the MacBook Pro 13-inch, what with the M1 chipset, what's a 13.3-inch display, and then the MacBook Pro 14-inch is a 14.2-inch display with that M1 Max chipset inside it. For screen resolution, as you can see here, the MacBook Pro 13-inch has still a great Retina display with a resolution of 2560 by 1600, but the MacBook Pro 14-inch with that M1 Max has a 3024 by 1964 resolution. And that is from top to bottom, and also does include that notch going right up to the top beyond that notch on the 14-inch MacBook Pro. For pixels per inch on the 13-inch MacBook Pro, we have 227 pixels per inch or PPI, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch we have 254 pixels per inch PPI, so a slight increase here on the 14-inch MacBook Pro. Then display refresh rate, I kind of already covered this already, but we'll go over it again. The 13-inch MacBook Pro has a 60Hz refresh rate, where the MacBook Pro 14-inch has a 120Hz refresh rate, or up to 120Hz refresh rate, with that adaptive ProMotion display, that liquid retina XDR display. Then for brightness and true tone, so the standard kind of brightness, the MacBook Pro has a 500 nits, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch has a standard 1000 nits. It can go higher than this, but the standard nits sort of display for just everyday use is 1000. And both of these screens have that true tone technology inside them. So next is the processor and CPU, and there's some big changes here between the Apple M1 and the Apple M1 Max, and that's what I'm going to compare against here. The Apple M1 has a 8-core CPU and an 8-core GPU, whereas the M1 Max, you can spec it all the way up to a 32-core GPU, and there are 10-core CPU inside this machine. It is a real powerhouse in comparison. And then for RAM amounts, for the MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1, you can choose 8 or 16 gigabytes of RAM, and now with the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max, you can choose between 16, 32 and 64 gigabytes of RAM. And I believe for the Max variety, you can only choose 32 and 64 gigabytes, whereas the 16 gigabytes is more reserved for the Pro. Next is the storage amounts, and on the MacBook Pro 13-inch, you can pick between 256 gigabytes all the way up to 2 terabytes, and with the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max chipset inside it, you can choose from 512 gigabytes all the way up to 8 terabytes with this option. Then ports, and this is where there's some big changes again. So the MacBook Pro 13-inch M1 only has 2 USB-C ports, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max inside it, well, all of the 14-inch MacBook Pros, has 3 times USB-C ports, and these are USB 4 and Thunderbolt 4, and also we've got the return of MagSafe, we've also got a HDMI port, and we've also got an SD XE card slot as well.
Then moving on to operating system, both of these machines will support the latest operating system, so that will be macOS Monterey, and both of these machines will get lots of updates for years to come. But more likely than not, the MacBook Pro 14-inch M1 Max will probably get an extra year of support, probably over the MacBook Pro 13-inch. But both of these machines at the time of making this video are so new, you're going to get loads of updates to come, so nothing to worry about at the moment. Moving on to battery life, the MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1 chipset inside it has up to a 20-hour battery life, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch M1 Max has up to 17 hours of battery life. You've got to remember the M1 chipset uses far less power because it's got far less cores, so it's going to give you a better battery life with that. Then moving on to charging, the MacBook Pro 13-inch has a USB-C 61-watt charger. What's a bit disappointing is that just leaves you with one USB port less unless you use an adapter, what has a USB-C in it as well to gain that one back. Whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch actually has a MagSafe with 96 watts inside it for the M1 Max, and you get the freedom of using all of those USB-C ports as well.
So just quickly guys, as we're going through the specs review, this channel has just got over 260,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. So on this channel right now, I'm doing a giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max in Sierra Blue and 128 gigabytes of storage inside. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And all I want to know in the comments below with your chance to win this iPhone 13 Pro Max in this international giveaway is put in the comments of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in the next year. Write it down in the comments below, and also at the same time, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell, because when we get over 300,000 subscribers, and only when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I'll be announcing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now, just a quick note I just want to add here, there might be some scammers out there who say you may have won a prize and to WhatsApp you. This is not me. As I said, when we get over 300,000 subscribers, that is when I'll be announcing who the winner is. Also at the same time guys, if you're liking this video so far, please do press the like button. Right, let's go back to those specs reviews.
Moving on to the weight, there are some differences here. The MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1 weighs 1.4 kilograms, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Max weighs 1.6 kilograms, because it is a slightly larger model. For Bluetooth technology, both of these machines have Bluetooth 5.0, so there's no differences there. But then for the webcam, this is where there are some big changes. So the MacBook Pro 13-inch has a single lens with a 720p camera in the top, whereas the MacBook Pro 14-inch actually has a notch design now with a 1080p camera behind it. So next to the price next. Now I have been talking about the 14-inch MacBook Pro M1 Max, but the actual starting price for 14-inch model is actually an M1 Pro, and that starts at $1,999 US, and that will give you the base model of 512 gigabytes, whereas the MacBook Pro 13-inch starts at $1,299 US, and this will give you a 256 gigabyte of storage. Moving on though, if we did a comparison of the MacBook Pro 14-inch now with the actual M1 Max inside it, the actual starting price is $3,099 US, but this will give you a 1 terabyte of storage in the base model. And then you can see the differences compared to that, say, MacBook Pro 13-inch with the M1 chipset inside it. Then finally, for both of these MacBook Pros, you have color choices, and there are two choices. There is the silver, and there is also the space gray for both of these models. So the big question is, will you be buying a new MacBook Pro?
So as you can see guys, the M1 Max is an absolute powerhouse, and especially in the 14-inch MacBook Pro. And that 14-inch MacBook Pro is absolutely incredible with all those extra new features. However, the M1 chipset in the 13-inch MacBook Pro is still an incredible MacBook to buy. So if you are on a budget and you're thinking of getting yourself a new MacBook Pro, it is still a worthy buy. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest reviews and also the latest Apple news and comparisons like this one, please do press the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you really soon. Bye bye.